I'm out here on Barton Creek, outside of Austin. And it's at times like this, when you're out in the countryside and it's still, you can really contemplate and clear out your mind. And it just makes me think about all the things that we've seen unfold in the last few decades. How things that we know are classical tyranny and oppression, and that we know are incredibly dangerous historically, are all unfolding in front of us. Just 4 days ago, in front of Congress, the Joint Chiefs of Staff and the Secretary of Defense told the Congress that they no longer have any authority over war, and that the President serves the United Nations and NATO. And impeachment resolution has been introduced if Obama doesn't back off from this. And it's not in one single newspaper in the United States. And this has been introduced since the 8th, a day after the statements. And of course, Obama last year said that they could launch wars in Libya without congressional approval because he had UN approval. Just amazing to see our country and military run by that foreign consortium controlled by the big six mega banks. But that's not why I'm talking here today. I have a sense of sorrow and a sense of foreboding when we see the NDAA and Obama yesterday signed the bill to arrest people under felonies for protesting, the so-called federal trespassing bill. You're on the federal mall or anywhere else, for that matter, that's under federal control. Worse than even what Russia's doing today, going after protesters. It's just incredible. And to see the communist Chinese come out, it was in Reuters 2 days ago, and pass their own NDAA and say to civil rights groups and others, hey, don't complain at us. This is modeled after the NDAA. But the main issue I want to make here, what I really want to burn in, is that I've studied the architects of this global system. I've read hundreds of their documents, well, more than that. I've made films about it. We've written articles at Infowars.com ad nauseum. They are scientific dictators. They call it the final revolution. And they want to end the family. They want to end sovereignty. They want to end private farms. They want to end all independent small business. It's called Agenda 21. And you've got to go read their writings. You've got to understand they intend to carry this plan out. This isn't just mega banks conquering Europe through derivatives and Time magazine announcing, hey, Goldman Sachs has conquered Europe. And that was a headline. Banker coup over Europe. Those mega banks controlling the derivatives in the fiat currency are run by eugenicists. The Rockefeller family on record funded the Kaiser Wilhelm Institute for Eugenics that literally set Hitler up. This is serious business. People need to understand that we're all in grave peril, and that we don't just have some corrupt corporate empire that just wants power. The globalists want to play God, and everybody is in their crosshairs. That's why they put the fluoride in the water, the GMO on record, sterilizing every mammal species it comes in contact with within three generations, organ failure. Look it up and look at all the diseases and cancer rates and everything skyrocketing. We are under assault. And I know in this media age of all this chatter and all this hype, real information gets lost in the background. But folks, you better realize that this is hardcore. I know a lot of you do know that. We've got to talk about what we can do together to try to defeat this tyranny. But I suggest you go out in the countryside, wherever you live, and just walk around and see nature and try to get centered and realize what a threat we're all under. Because the globalists don't want to enslave us. They want to enslave us so they can then reduce our population. Between 80 and 90%, depending on which UN document you look at, Club of Rome, CFR, all of it. It's all there. Please, please. They're setting up secret arrest squads and announcing all of this tyranny because they intend to use it. Remember, just 5 years ago, people would say, oh, the government doesn't spy on you without warrants. Now federal courts are saying, hey, the police can pull you over without a warrant, just download your phone. Hey, we'll put you in jail as a felony for protesting. We can't let their intimidation make us back off. You know, a lot of people say, Alex, you're scaring people. Well, facts are facts, and I don't think you're cowards. I don't think you're cowards. I think when I state the facts to you, you'll understand the only way out is resisting this. And I want to say to the bureaucracy out there, think about your family. Think about the future. You're going to be destroyed by this system as well. This is a scientific scorched earth policy, similar to when people would resist the Romans. They would burn down the city state that they took over and then kill all of the male children and men. Sometimes they'd kill everybody. The Israelites would do that as well. They'd come in and kill everybody once they'd taken over. And the point is, it's called total war. If you read Last of the Mohicans or watch the film, which is based as a composite on a lot of true events that took place, but it's fiction. One of the Indian tribe, you know, going after the folks that are allied with the English, says, I'm going to kill you, but before you die, know that your seed is wiped from the earth. And the globalists will not bury the hatchet until we're all dead. This isn't entertainment. It's not a joke. It's not me trying to be shocking. For God's sakes, you better look into what I've told you now. You better think for yourselves. And you better look at the documents. Because this world government being openly set up now, and the butchering of our basic freedoms in front of everybody right now, is the beginning of the end. Once the globalists have their world government, they've said it's only a straitjacket to then carry out every form of evil you can imagine against the population. These people are beyond evil. Stop being naive. Look at history. Realize what I'm telling you is true. And understand that our military is now run by the UN. World government's now openly being announced. They're openly saying they'll secretly arrest us and disappear us into the night. Please understand, all of you that even serve the system, even those of you that think you have power because you serve evil, you're going to be destroyed by this as well. Defend your families. Defend the innocents. Defend the basic liberties that were so hard fought for and so hard won. Bondage is a terrible thing. It's humiliating. The government has its war paint on, the police in their black uniforms, the black ski mask, the helicopters, their surveillance. It's all about making the American people the enemy. And the same systems being standardized worldwide, police and military. It's time to wake up and decide what side you serve. Don't say that you weren't warned. Don't say later that you wish you'd have done something. All you've got to do is speak up. All you've got to do is get involved. All you've got to do is say no to evil. That's all that tyrants need to flourish, is that good men and women do nothing. All right, I'll cover this more on the radio, but I just was having a contemplation moment, and it just hit me how real all this is, and how we've got to work now before things get a lot worse to turn this around.